everybody, welcome to Greenhouse. Today we're going to hear a story that you've heard before about the prodigal son, but it's told with a little bit of a different twist. Let's light the candle to get started. There we go. Our call to worship is from Psalm 47. Come in, come in, come one, come all. Lift your heart, clap your hands. Shout joy. Sing praises to our God, the highest one, the majesty of majesties. Come see the world from God's point of view. In him, the victory has already been won. All that troubles us is overcome. Under our feet, in him we are at home. Come, come claim your inheritance. Come home to his love. So let's lift our hearts and shout joy and sing praises with a praise song. And today we're going to sing Good, Good Father, which is a great song that goes with our story today about how the father welcomes back his son into his loving arms. So stand up if you'd like and sing from your heart, Good, Good Father. Wow, I just think that is so beautiful. It's really touching. Actually makes me get kind of teary-eyed. So, okay. Next, we're gonna do our confession. It helps us to worship with joy. And so we pray together. Father, now that we've been called and we're gathered to worship and we're praising you, we'll confess our sins. We want to learn and grow in you. We know that you love us. You're our good, good Father. Help us confess our sins to you so we can worship with joy. Father, we've sinned against you by loving things other than you. Forgive us. We've disobeyed you or our parents or teachers. Forgive us. Lord, help us to have a strong relationship with you and forgive us when we think of ourselves before you or other people. Forgive us. Thank you that you're so kind, Father, and you sent your Son to take away our sins. Open our hearts and ears to learn more about you. Amen. Today's scripture is from Luke. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John in the New Testament. So let's get to Luke. And the verse is Luke 15, the chapter and verse is Luke 15, 22 through 24. So let's get to Luke 15. Okay. 22 through 24. But the father said to his servants, "Quick, bring the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Bring the fattened calf and kill it. Let's have a feast and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He is lost. He was lost and is found." So they began to celebrate. So I'm sure you've all read the book or maybe seen the movie or at least heard a story about Aladdin. Well, Aladdin and his wonderful lamp. In one version of the story, Aladdin worked in a shop that exchanged new lamps for old ones. And Aladdin's job was to polish the lamps and make them look like new. So in Bible times, there were different kinds of lamps. Here's something I found. It's called ancient oil lamps of the Holy Land. And you would put oil inside these lamps and then you would light it here and a flame would come out. And here's one of them. You can see this lamp is this one right here. And this actually has been lit. You can see the soot around it. And there's a cross here. So there's a lamp. Some lamps were made out of pottery, like this. Other lamps were shiny, made out of brass or metal, like these. Or like this one. This looks like the lamp from the Disney movie of Aladdin's story, doesn't it? So, one day, as Aladdin was polishing the lamp, a genie came out. Have you ever seen a picture like this? There he is, rubbing the lamp, making it shiny, and out popped a genie. And the genie that came out of the lamp promised to grant Aladdin anything he wished for. And with the help of the genie, Aladdin gained great wealth and eventually won the love of a beautiful princess. So, wouldn't it be wonderful to have your every wish come true? Whew! You might think so. But the truth is, sometimes the things we wish for aren't so good for us. And that's what this young man discovered in today's Bible story from Luke 15. Our Bible story is about a man who had three wishes, just like Aladdin. So this man's three wishes, he wanted a lot of money, he wanted to travel and see the world, and he wanted to be his own boss. Well, the young man got his wishes in this Bible story, but they were not granted to him by a genie. Nope. The young man went to his father and asked his father to give him his inheritance, the money that would be his when his father died. He wanted it now. So even though his father was sad that his son wanted to leave, he gave him his share of the family fortune And the young man left home and traveled around the world. And he visited all the places that he wanted to see and did whatever he wanted to do. And he was so happy that nobody was telling him what to do. And since the young man had a lot of money, if he saw something he wanted, he bought it. And since he had a lot of money, he also had a lot of friends. This sounds like a happy story, doesn't it? Well, that's not the end of the story. After a while, the young man ran out of money. And when he ran out of money, his friends ran out on him. He was so desperate that he went to work for a man who sent him to feed his pigs. The young man was so hungry that he would have gladly eaten the food that he was given to feed the pigs with. As he looked at the filthy pig pen, he thought about the mess he had made of his life. And he thought about his father and the home he had left behind. "Even a servant in my father's house lives better than this," the man said to himself. "I will return to my father and tell him that I'm sorry for the way I behaved and ask him to forgive me and give me a job as one of his servants." Do you think the father was willing to take him back? Not as a servant, but yes, he was. He welcomed him back home as his son. "Let's have a feast and celebrate, for this son of mine was lost, but now he's found," the father said. So the story had a happy ending after all. And this story that Jesus told is really a story about you and me as well, and sometimes the way we behave. Sometimes you and I make bad choices, just like the man in the story in Luke. We sometimes wish for things that aren't good for us. We don't want to listen to God and obey what the Bible tells us we should do. When we act that way, we really make a mess of our lives. And well, I have really good news for you. Just like the Father in the story, God, our Heavenly Father, our good, good Father, is always willing to take us back if we admit we're wrong and that we want to return to Him. It's wonderful. And that's why when I watch that video, it makes me feel happy and emotional, because I know how much He loves us and what a good, good Father He is to us. So let's pray. Dear Father, we sometimes make bad choices. Thank you for being a loving Father, a good, good Father who will always take us back when we come home to you. Amen. Let's sing our doxology together to finish. Scripture in this story today. I hope you did too. I'll see you soon. Bye, Greenhouse friends.